Today, I'm going to show you in a minute how to make an amazing book cover that will stand out in the marketplace. Plus, we're going to explore three different free online book cover creator to help you easily create your own custom book cover that will attract potential buyers. And I'm also going to share with you a secret website to get prompts for your book cover so that you wouldn't have to start scouting for prompts all over the internet. And to wrap it up, I'm going to show you an amazing AI tools that will help you bring your book cover design to life. So by the end of this tutorial, you will be able to make this kind of book covers for both your fiction and your non-fiction books. But before we proceed, please click on the subscribe button if you're new to my channel. I like this video to help other self-publishers to find this video. Plus, YouTube algorithm would love it more. Without further ado, let's get started. Right here is leonardo.ai. And once you're on this platform, all you need to do is just to click on the launch app to either sign in or log in. And you'll be brought up to this interface. So this is the daily token, which is about 150. So use it wisely. Now scroll down and you click on image generation, and there you'll be brought up to this interface, and here is where we are going to generate our book cover. But first thing first, you would need to adjust the number of images you would want to generate at once. So I love to keep mine at either one or two so I don't get to exhaust my daily token. So the next thing you want to do is you want to work on your image dimension, okay? So get the right dimension for your book cover. So over here, you want to change the fine tool model to Leonardo diffusion. And if you look closely, this is an illustration about a little prince sitting on a crescent moon. And it's surrounded by a whimsical characters and objects, okay? And over here, it is said that the book title should be written in an italic font style. And down below, I said the illustration is placed at the center of the cover and the book title above it and the author's name below it. So the next thing you want to do is to click on generate and wait for it. And there you go, guys. So if you look closely, this is the image and it is true to the prompt, okay? Which was him sitting on a crescent moon and surrounded by some kind of object and characters, and there you go. But the truth is, if you don't like this image, you can actually regenerate another. So here is exactly what you need to do. Now head back here and click on generate, and there you go, guys. So this is another image Leonardo AI just generated. So I think these images are not bad. They are true to the prompt. And one thing is, if you want this image, all you need to do is to come over here. So now click over here where you say download image. And so what this feature does, it makes the image into a video. And this is the image upscaler. You can actually use this to also get a better quality of this image. And here is the image guidance. So if you really want to create a lookalike of this particular image, all you need to do is just to use this prompt and you're good to go, okay? Now the next book cover generator is Diagram. This is quite popular among product designers. So we're going to use the same prompt we used on Leonardo AI. However, you can always use a different prompt because their models are obviously different. Now I'll go ahead and paste in a prompt, and over here is the settings. All you need to do is just to adjust it to suit your need. And you click on the generate button and wait for the AI to generate something pretty nice for you. And there you go, guys. So this is looking absolutely very simple. Am I permitted to call this like a minimal style? However, this is not a bad design. This is still good. And one thing you can actually do is you can retry if probably you don't like the images, or you can actually use the remix button to get something similar to this. So I'm also going to remix and retry using this guide. And there you go. So I think I love this output. This is looking much better. And I think I love this image with a sparkling design. This is actually perfect for the book, guys. And remember, another thing you can always work on is the prompt. So if you want this image, all you need to do is to click over here. And now these are the options you can try out. So click on download to have it downloaded to your device. And let me know what you think about Ideogram AI. If this is your first time with this platform or you've been using it to generate images of all kinds. And up next is the last book cover generator and obviously not the least. So head over to Microsoft Bing Creator. So once you're signed up or you're logged in, you'll be brought up to this interface, okay? We're still going to use the same prompt and all of that. So click on the create button to have your images. Amazing, guys, I'm thrilled. This is so beautiful, this is so amazing. The colors are on point. And if you look closely, guys, the titles are without errors. They are all well spelled. And you know what, guys? I think I want to generate another. I'm loving this. So all I'll need to do is to click on the create button again. And there you go. Beautiful. So I think once it comes to book cover creation, I think Microsoft Bing seems to be on top of its game, right? So let me know what you think about these three book cover book generators I just showed you guys, your most preferred. And like I said, they all did a good job. We can always work on the prompts to get the best out of it, okay? So this is a very beautiful book cover design. And there are three things you are most likely to do once you're settled for the design you want to work with. And this is you upscaling the image for better quality, then removing any unwanted objects, characters, or even text from the design. And lastly, removing the background, okay? So I'm going to show you how to do this real quick. It's a free AI tool I discovered, and it's so efficient. So you come over here to download the image. And this is what it actually looks like. I think I love this crescent image. It carries a face, which is actually very lovely. So now this will lead us to the next phase where we're going to work on our design, okay? So what you need to do is to head over to this website. I will leave the website name in my description box to make it very easy for you. The one thing you can always do here, upscale the image for better quality, remove the background in your image, and lastly, object remover feature, and let's click on it to use this feature. So I'm just going to erase this. And there you go, guys. That's pretty easy. As you can see, we don't have the text anymore. So just click on the download button. So the text we have down below has been removed. Pretty nice, right? So the next thing you want to do is just remove the background, which is basically very simple. You can do that yourself. Then the next thing I want to show you is the image upscaler feature. I'm just going to upload our image. And there you go, guys. So this is the before and after. I'm going to download it so that we can see the difference. So this is the clear view of the image. I think it's looking pretty okay. All the objects and colors are looking very sharp. So one thing you should know is this is the front cover of your book. So you need the back cover, okay? And if you're new to making book cover, this might seem like an old art of artwork for you. But don't worry, I'm going to walk you through exactly how to do that, okay? So right now, we're going to remove some objects here and this text, including this moon and this guy. And there you go, guys. So all unwanted images and text has been removed. That easy, okay? So this will be our back cover. And one thing you want to do is you want to merge it together. If you intend to publish your book on Amazon KDP, then you will find this super helpful, okay? So now head over to Canva. So I will be using the most popular book cover dimension, okay? So click on create new design and you'll be brought up to this interface. So Canva is all about drag and drop. Now click on the download feature and upload the images you just downloaded. So just tap on the images to have it on the blank space. Now place it side by side. And the next thing you want to do is just to stretch them across and ensure they are both equal. And once you do, and the next thing you want to do is to add a text. And this will be like a snippet to the story, okay? And there you go. We've got a very beautiful book cover, and this is how you get to design your book cover, okay? Pretty simple and amazing, right? So let me know what you think about the three AI book cover generator I just shared with you guys, which is more effective and efficient. So this is bringing us to the end of this tutorial. But before we wrap it up, I did promise to share with you guys a secret website where you can actually get prompt for your book covers, right? Okay, so head over to this website and I'll show you how to use it. So we have several book covers here, okay? Over here is family book cover, crime book cover, motivational book cover, story book cover, educational book cover, cartoon book cover, and all of that, okay? So I'm just going to show you how to get the prompt. So over here, you've got a lot of book covers. And let's say your book is about astronaut or whatsoever. I'm going to click on it. And there you go, guys. So we've got more information about this book. So you have to scroll down to the very bottom. And this place where you have it say Midjourney prompt for this book. This is the prompt you will be using. But before you use this prompt on a different AI, you need to take off these features. This is strictly for Midjourney, okay? So all you need to do is just to copy this part and paste it into any book generator of your choice, okay? And that's it. It is free to use. So if your book genre is fantasy, then this book cover will do. You will be able to generate something as similar to this. So all you need to do is just to copy a prompt. So this is how you get to copy prompts all for free. However, there are several platforms that you can actually get this. You can use ChatGPT to come up with a unique prompt for you. With this website, I don't think you can get it wrong. It has over 9,000 designs. Can you beat that? So let me know what you think about this tutorial, if it was super helpful. And if you have any question, please do let me know in the comment section. And when you subscribe, just tell me, Christine, I just subscribed. And guess what? I will be sending you sweet, sweet hugs, okay? Thank you so very much. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.